Mike Corliss with Tormach. Today we're going to talk about slitting saw arbors and how to use them. Here's a couple of the slitting saw arbors that Tormach offers. This one's for slitting saws with a half inch hole in them. Okay. And this one you'll tighten with a spanner inch. Okay. And then the other model has a 1 inch for slitting saws with a 1 inch hole. Okay. Here's a couple of the slitting saws Tormach offers. These have the 1 inch hole in them. When you mount a slitting saw, what you want to do is have the cutting force so it will tighten the screw, okay? Like right now, the cutting force is going to push this way, and that will tighten the screw, and that's what you want. I haven't really had one loosen up on me if you put it on backwards, but it could, so to be safe, just make sure when you mount your slitting saw, the cutting force would tighten the screw, okay? It's got a hole in the arbor, put a pin in there, and use a wrench and tighten it down. Okay? The advantage of using a slitting saw, I only cut an eighth inch deep, but you can cut thin widths fairly deep compared to the diameter of or how wide they are. Okay? If you're going to use an end mill to do this, if you're going to cut a 3/16 wide slot, say a half inch deep with an end mill, it's going to require a lot of passes. But with a slitting saw, you can do it a lot fewer passes, and it's going to be a lot straighter than if you peck away at it with an end mill. What you want to use them for, thin, deep slots. It's just a lot easier to do it. If your machining geometry allows for it. If it's a through slot like this, it's a lot easier to cut it with a slitting saw than a small end mill. Sometimes your part geometry won't allow for it, but if you can, it cuts fairly quick and your size is going to hold there if you happen to have a slot the same size as your slitting saw.